Hi there guys, welcome to another episode. As you can see, I've got the daily driver in and I'm doing a job that I've already done once before, and this is the clutch master cylinder. Now, as I said, I've done this once before. I did film it. I've got all the footage of it, but I never did anything with it. But now I've got the problem back again, so I need to do it again. So I'll show you what the problem is and what the problem was last time I did this job, and this time, well, it's exactly the same. So I'll show you now what the problem is and then we'll start pulling the car apart.
Right, so the car's been stood for a few hours, so the problem I've got now is that the clutch, as you see, kind of drops about halfway down. I've got a clutch, that little bit, but it's not a lot. Once I let go of the clutch, it stays there, so I have to hook it back up again. It will drop down again, and I've got to clutch the last little bit. If I then pump the clutch, I've got now quite a good clutch. If I now drive the car and I don't use the clutch for a while, I'm going to go back to the same problem, that as you press the clutch, it drops to the floor and it stays down there.
Right, so I've got it up in there a little tiny bit. I don't want too much, but basically we're going to go in there somewhere, right down the back of there. So we need to get rid of the air filter box, the battery and its box, to get to one end of the pedal, which is where the hoses go in and out. So all this lot's got to come out of the way. We have to get rid of this tray up here as well. It's the bottom half of the tray. This top part can stay, but the bottom half has to go. So there's a couple of bolts, one behind there and one behind there. There's some little clips on here. We can pull that whole tray out of the way. The air filter box is just, I think it's just pressed in with some rubber plugs. So that is just release it here and the electrical connector and the hose clip, and that whole box will come out of the way. The battery is then bolted in with a clamp across the top and three bolts in the battery tray, and that gets that out of the way. After that, we can start looking at the actual clutch master cylinder, which is in all the way behind the battery there. Right, so that's the air filter box out of the way, battery box out of the way. These bolts for the battery tray are a nightmare. They're usually really, really rusty. I think one of these I had to drill out last time and put a new bolt in there, so they're a nightmare. This one was tough now, so I'm going to re-thread that one as well, just to make sure that it can go back together again. Now, the last time I did this job, I didn't put it up on YouTube, and the reason for that is because I wasn't happy with the quality of the film. And the reason I wasn't happy with the quality of the film was because I didn't have a light like I've got now. So we're now looking at, we can now get in here and we can see where the master cylinder is. Well, actually we can't. But I'll try and show you. The master cylinder is actually there, right back there. So at the moment I can see an electrical connector on it. There's the hose here coming from the reservoir down to the master cylinder, and that has a little blue clip on it that you may be able to see there. So it's got a little blue clip on it there. So you pull that up, we'll be able to get the hose off. And that is basically it that needs to be done underneath the bonnet. Now that will, that hose has got brake fluid in it, so I need to empty part of the reservoir, at least down to below that level there. Otherwise it's gonna run brake fluid everywhere. So I'm gonna empty that of brake fluid now and disconnect that hose there. And then we're pretty much done inside the engine bay. We need to move to the inside of the car then. Right, so the hose with the blue tab on, I've twisted it up there, so it's still attached to the reservoir up there, but I've twisted it up there, so that opening is now above the reservoir, so it won't leak out anymore. And then the metal hose is down here. This is the one that goes to the master cylinder. No, this is the one that goes down to the slave cylinder. And on the end here, you'll see that it's got that black piece of plastic here, and then it's got a gap at the end there, and on the gap there is where that little rubber plug sits. So you need to make sure that little rubber plug sits there, otherwise that hose has to try and seal against the plastic and it won't do it. So it's a little loose bit of rubber that's a really bad design, but you need to be aware of it. Right, I had the same problem last time and I've had the same problem this time. There's two things that you need to be really, really careful of when you're taking it apart. One of them is this little tiny rubber grommet here that goes on the hose that goes in there. So in there there's a hose that goes in, then it clicks in with that little metal clip that holds it in, and when you take the hose out, that rubber doesn't normally come with it, so it gets left inside there, and then when you pull the pedal out it drops off and falls somewhere, God knows where. So I knew about it this time and I knew to get it, but I still tried to fish it out and I still managed to drop it and had to find it on the floor. So that's a little bit of rubber that lives inside there, and it goes on the hose that goes in that hole. So make sure you find that and make sure you have it for when you put it back together again. The other thing is the clip. Now the clip, I see I've got a new clip on here that comes with it, but if you don't get a new clip then you need to save that one, and it flies everywhere. So be careful with that one. So when you pull these off, basically you just press down on these two tabs here and the clip will drop off, but it does tend to drop off at quite speed and you lose it. So you need to be careful about them. Other than that, it's a fairly simple job to get both the hoses undone. This one's just the little blue clip that I showed you, and all you do is you press the blue bit in and pull the hose off, and that's that. And I usually just bend it up. You can twist the hose upwards and turn it up, and so that you don't get oil pouring everywhere. And this one is the hose that goes from here to the actual clutch slave cylinder, and it has this little rubber thing. So don't lose that rubber thing, make sure you keep hold of it. Right, so in the car I've took away the panel across the bottom there. It is basically sat with clips, so there's just a few clips there, clipped in at the bottom, but there is one screw there that needs taken off. Other than that, that panel comes off quite easily. And the clutch pedal itself is held on by three bolts. So we've got one there, there, and then we've got one hiding, and another one right up the top, just there. So there's four bolts holding the clutch pedal in place. So once those four bolts are out of place, we can pull the whole pedal out. If I remember right, this cable here that goes to the clutch for the starter, that is sat inside that bracket there, and it is a nightmare to get out. I think I broke mine, so it's just kind of poked in there just to keep it there. But they are horrible otherwise to get out. But the pedal itself is quite easy. It's just four bolts and it comes out. Now, I know last time I did this, I read on the internet that you have to take the steering column off, but, and I know I didn't, and you don't have to. What's in the way is the clutch switch. Now that fits in that little hole there, and it basically just twists. So you twist it out like that, that's out of the way. It gives you that little bit extra wiggle room to get the pedal out, and that is the pedal out. You don't need to undo the whole of the steering column. So that makes it a lot easier. And there is the offending article. So we're going to get this over to the bench now, and we're going to remove this from the bracket and replace it with the new one. Right, so over at the bench, we've got the whole pedal assembly here. Now the master cylinder itself is actually just twisted into the bracket here, but it does have a little clip that goes into the pedal there. We can have a look at the new one there, and you'll see the clip that goes into the pedal. So you push that into the pedal, that clips it in, and then it twist locks into place. To get that out, obviously, you need to squeeze that together and then pull that out, and then we can twist the pedal off. So it's a bit fiddly, but we'll get that done now. Right, so that's the old one taken out, and basically it just twists, and they're really, really tight. So one of these holes is slightly bigger than the others, and then there's a lug on there that's slightly bigger than the other ones, so you can't really get it wrong. So once you get it right, it kind of drops in. Obviously you need to make sure you get that plastic piece in first, and then it's a matter of just twisting it. And like I say, it's really tight. So I'm going to do both hands. Like that. So make sure you click those two in, otherwise it won't work. And then it's turn it around, and I've basically just put it so that those two are straight up in line with the pedal. So that's that done. I just have to get it back into the car, bolt it all up, and then we have to start to bleed the hoses. Put the hoses on and start to bleed it. Now it does come with a new gasket, so I'm going to fit that as well. And that fits somewhere there. And that fits just there. So I'm going to stick to that, and then get it back in the car. Right, so this is the hose that has the rubber grommet on it. We're going to fit that to that hose and make sure that it's definitely there. The hole for it is there, and that's where we're going to put it in now. The clip is already there, so just pushing that in there should make it clip into place. And there's the click. So that is now in there, and it's sealed. The other hose from the reservoir now fits onto the top hose, and that again just clicks into place. Can I get it there? Might have to press it. Right, and that's all the way in there, and I can't pull it back off again now. So that is now attached. So both the hoses are now attached where they should be. All that's left to do then is to bleed the system, which in Ford's amazing wisdom, I don't understand why, but they put the bleed nipple there. So they put the bleed nipple there, which is a horrible place to put it because you can't really get to it. And it's one that you can't put a tool on either. So you have to undo it by hand, which is also, I can't use a tool on there, so I have to use it by hand. Down. Up. Oh god. Down. And up. So I did have a problem with this, and that was as we started to bleed it, this did start to leak, and I think I had the same problem last time.
and I took it apart, pushed it back together again, and I think hopefully it just wasn't pushed in far enough. Worst case scenario is that I need to change that little rubber on the end of there, but at the moment it seems sealed. So I think that's done now. So
it's all nicely bled down there now. Brake fluid all over the floor. We'll clean that up in a few minutes. I've put a little bit of copper grease inside these holes here for where the battery tray goes on. So I'm now going to put the battery tray back on again and the air filter box and build the car back up again, basically. And then we can go out for a test drive. Right, all back together again. Can't give it a road test. Well, that finally feels like a totally different car. Clutch is absolutely brilliant, doesn't stick to the ground anymore. So, if you like what you've seen in this episode, you want to see some more, like and press that subscribe button. I'll see you in the next episode. Thanks a lot, and bye-bye.